If you're looking for the best gaming PC, here's a list you must see. We made this list based on our personal preference and sorted it based on their features, prices, quality, durability, and reputation of the manufacturers and customer feedback. Also, we've included options for every type of customer. So let's get started. At the first position of our list, we have Omen by HP GT13-0090. This model by HP Omen has a 10th generation Intel core in an E10850K chipset. It has 10 cores, 20 threads, 20 MB cache, 3.60 GHz base frequency, and 5.20 GHz boost frequency. On the graphics side, HP Omen contains UHD Graphics 630 and the latest RTX 3090 graphics card. It has 24GB video RAM, GDDR6X memory type, 1400 MHz base clock, and 1700 MHz boost clock. HP Omen 30L is the most powerful gaming desktop at this time with the latest graphics card and processor. Incredibly fast and powerful processing, having massive 32GB RAM and 1TB local storage. How well HP Omen 30L is for gaming? As for gaming performance, this beast is highly capable of providing the best results for the most popular games and can do its best for future games too. Its Omen Gaming Hub is extremely useful for boosting and tweaking the gaming to a great extent. You are getting the best experience in overclocking thanks to the next generation CPU along with RTX 30 graphics card. HP Omen is a fourth gaming PC with solid frame rates. For games like Cyberpunk 2077 and Microsoft Flight Simulation, it gives more than 80 FPS. Whereas, for Borderlands 3, Hitman 3, you are getting up to 100 FPS on 2106 type resolution. Not only this, but you can have advanced ray tracing and virtual reality games too. The chassis of the PC is spacious enough to allow the future upgrading, which is hardly required. Not up to 2 solid years for sure, since the configuration the manufacturer has stacked in is indeed futuristic. Following the interior, it has an RGB cooler master 120M fan and liquid cooling of CPU, which efficiently reduces heat production and keeps the components workable under the pressure. It has a tempered glass panel through which you can peek in, though it is a little bit extra to get in from outside. However, the case is easily openable for upgrading. Moving on to the next at number 2, Skytech Prism Roman 2. Skytech Prism Roman 2 contains 5th generation AMD Ryzen 7 5800X processor with 8 core 16 threads, 32MB cache, 3.8 GHz base, and 4.7 GHz boost frequency. However, Skytech Prism Roman 2 offers the same great performance as HP Omen 30L because of the RTX 3090 within the system, although this will cost you $1,000 less comparatively. With 24GB of huge video memory and being compatible with virtual reality, this gaming PC can deal with all of the graphic-intensive games of today. One of the best parts of this gaming PC for which this unit stands alone is the Seagate Fur Q2521TB Gen 4 SSD. The fastest of all and incredibly powerful compared to the usual NVMe SSD. And not to forget the 32GB massive RAM at disposal. Of course, you wouldn't expect RTX 3090 Plus in an eCPU to perform parallel with RTX 3090 Plus Ryzen 7 CPU. But it does surely not fall into any bad category performance at all. This packed configuration is extremely powerful and eligible for high-end gaming. As mentioned earlier, RTX 3090 is a good luck charm for fork gaming. Though here we have tested this configuration at 1080p gaming instead of fork, which was pretty obvious to get UPAR. Therefore, trying out this at 1080p Ultra settings, we get 456 for GTAV, 222.5fps for Shadow of the Tomb Raider, 223fps for PUBG, 208fps for Forza Horizon, 1280.6 for Apex Legend, and 278 for Battlefield V. Power on the button and see the magic. This is the most glorifying and so beautifully designed gaming PC packed in a Fantex Metallic Gear Neo Cube case with a triple 360 radiator and a total of 9 ARC fans for optimal performance support like no other. The case is a dual glass tempered panel, showing off the neatness and professional cable management, having dust filters as well to protect the hardware from getting dirt specs and help them out to perform without any hindrance. Ryzen 7 5800X is known for getting hot the day it comes out into the market. but the features of this PC case, especially the liquid cooling, are so effective that there is no reason that could be found to rule it back. The number 3 position is held by Alienware Aurora R11. Alienware Aurora R11 contains Eisroth generation Intel Core i7-10700KF processor with 8 cores and 16 threads. It has 16 MB cache, 3.8 GHz base frequency, and 5.10 GHz boost frequency. As for graphics card, it owns RTX 3080 with 10 GB VRAM and GDDR6X memory type. It has 1400 MHz base clock and 1700 MHz boost clock, providing the same great performance similar to HP Omen 30L. Further, this gaming desktop offers 16 GB dual-channel HyperX Fury XMP RAM upgradable to up to 64 GB. There it has 1 TB SATA and 512 GB SSD storage form to utilize for big files and overhead performance. The main job of this gaming desktop is to provide flawlessly fast and smooth gaming no matter which game you like to play. The overclocking of both the CPU and GPU pushes the game to the next level. We have not experienced any lag nor it has stuttering when overclocked, which is a nice thing. It's a VR-ready gaming desktop. Also supports real-time ray tracing and advanced DLSS. It also matches the requirement for gaming at DirectX 12. The best you can do with Alienware is to play games at 1440p on ultra settings if you want to touch the trigger for the right target. At this resolution, you can easily get more than 70 FPS for Cyberpunk 2077, Borderlands 3, and Total War: Three Kingdoms. With Alien FX RGB lighting, this is a compact PC tower which is thoroughly designed, taking under consideration its attractiveness plus the strength it has to summon. The chassis is pretty cool and is very appealing to the eyes. The tool-free expansion base helps the customer to get in easily without beating out the bush. The liquid cooling in top to rear and venting system is also pretty good, although there is no glass-tempered side, but has done the designing innovatively. Further, the good part is the i/O ports are not difficult to reach without too much bending and tackling with wire mess. Next at number 4, we have Skytech Shadow 3.0 Gaming PC Desktop. Skytech gaming desktops mostly take in AMD processors, so it's this time too. This model has Ryzen 5 3606 core processor with 12 threads, 3.6 GHz base clock, and 4.2 GHz boost frequency. Whereas for video card, Skytech Shadow 3.0 owns the latest RTX 3060 Ti with 8 GB VRAM, GDDR6 memory type, 1410 MHz base clock, and 1600 MHz boost clock. It is a VR-ready GPU and also supports real-time ray tracing. Skytech Shadow 3.0 is equipped with all the necessary features which are important to get the smooth and tear-free gaming of any type of genre. The Ryzen 5 3600 processor can easily beat Intel IFIV in terms of cost and performance too. If you are planning to play games at 1440p, this pre-built gaming PC with RTX 3060 Ti video card can fetch you up to 60 frames per second. However, gaming at 1080p Ultra can do the job much efficiently instead. Results showed 30fps, 50fps, 58fps, and 68fps on Microsoft Flight Simulator, Cyberpunk 2077, Control, and Borderlands 3 respectively at 1440p. Rather than this, you can have 35fps, 77fps, 95fps, and 94fps at 1080p settings on these games. With a glossy touch, Skytech Shadow 3.0 is a standard-sized PC tower. It has all that fancy RGB LED lighting we mostly find in gaming desktops. Moreover, the glass-tempered glass is also going common among Skytech desktops mainly, letting you see the interior, which consists of 3 ARG fans and liquid cooling. The front of the tower is having an RGB strip, but the overall lighting effects is controllable via PC software. You can choose from cycling the colors, fade, and static modes. Although the gaming customization through the same application of Skytech didn't have much to offer other than the color palette. The number 5 position is held by Skytech Chronos Gaming PC Desktop. Skytech Chronos is offering more beefy game performance as compared to what Skytech Shadow 3.0 is capable of rendering. Chronos has an 8 cores AMD Ryzen 7 3700X processor with 16 threads, 3.6 GHz base clock, which goes up to 4.4 GHz boost clock. The video card it is stacking in is RTX 3070 8GB GDDR6 memory and a boost clock up to 1700 MHz. It has 16GB RAM and 1TB local storage in SSD form. Definitely Skytech is a best gaming PC and can do many of the graphics-intensive tasks single-handedly, although the price is more than Skytech Shadow. So does the configuration. Taking in mind the power it holds, we suggest you to buy this machine only if you have those high targets to achieve. Otherwise, you can have other cost-effective options under this same brand. Following up the imminent performance, this PC is good for gaming at 4K purely. High frame rates for the most popular games is absolutely achievable. Not only gaming, but we have found this desktop outperform many of the popular PC in terms of professionalism, including highly intensive editing in real time, 3D modeling, and animating. Looking at its design, it is oddly fancy for a professional animator or editor if he is at an office, since the dual ring 4 ARG fans and multiple color LED make this machine extraordinarily gawky. It may sound more good for a gamer than a professionally decent setup. Thus, if you are a true game enthusiast, that means this crazy exposure thrilled you more and can bring that gaming vibe which we often need to put the last year of excitement. Other than this, it is a standard size of PC tower with one-sided tempered glass to see the organs. The build is strong and reliable, and is having liquid cooling features to stay cool and give healthy performance. The number 6 position is dominated by HP Pavilion T-Gun 23W desktop. HP Pavilion is a mainstream gaming desktop. It has AMD Ryzen 5 3506 core processor. It has 6 threads, 19 MB cache, 3.6 GHz base frequency, and 4.1 GHz boost frequency. It owns an NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1650 Super graphics card. Having 4GB GDDR6 video memory, has 1530 MHz base clock and 1725 MHz boost clock. However, it has plenty of local storage in the form of 1TB of HDD and 1TB SSD and has 32GB RAM. The given model of HP Pavilion with a video card of 4GB is more likely a mainstream gaming PC, fulfilling the minimum requirement for PC games. The user who intends to play basic or casual gaming, HP Pavilion is a suitable pick for him. Although with this configuration, it is still not a budget-friendly gaming computer. Similarly, this PC could be an upgrade from an old desktop to an entry-level gaming rig. It's not like you are going to be disappointed. You can play few demanding games too other than less popular games, with rich frame rates at 1080 IP resolution flawlessly. It gives 60 FPS to 70 FPS smoothly while playing games like Gears Tactics, Hitman 2, Far Cry 5, Rise of the Tomb Raider, and Forza Horizon 4. It is also very suitable for VR gaming. HP Pavilion is a typically small-size PC tower with nothing fancy or extravagant. You are not getting any fancy looks, neither cutting-edge design nor RGB lighting here, which are nowadays trending among the gaming desktops. Even though it is a compact gaming desktop, it is not as boring as it might sound. The front is having creases with bottom-lit LED in green and a logo at bottom right. Ports are at the front for easy access. Due to the compactness of the case, it is a bit difficult to get in the chassis to upgrade. Moreover, the cooling mechanism is also not that satisfactory relative to the current gaming desktop's engineering. Therefore, the heat dissipation is lanky and non-optimal for the aggressive multitasking and overclocking of the components. Moving on to the next at number 7 with iBuypower 1000 EV2 desktop. iBuypower 1000 EV2 pre-built gaming PC is a mid-range desktop with plenty of power and features to accommodate gaming and multitasking. It has Intel Core i7 10700F8 core processor with 16 threads, 2.9 GHz base frequency, and 4.8 GHz boost frequency. It has GeForce RTX 2066GB GDDR6 video memory graphics card, which has a 1,365 MHz base clock and 1,680 MHz boost clock, with 16GB RAM, 480GB SSD, and 2TB HDD. You are all set to get the buttery game performance. Due to Intel i7 10700F8 core processor and the RTX 2060 video card, iBuypower 1000 EV2 with $100 more is a far better option than the HP Pavilion that is an entry-level gaming PC. The combination of the hardware is well chosen by the manufacturer. Although it is not a hybrid gaming PC with latest components, it is still a powerful desktop to get you into the intense gaming tournaments with all the necessary weapons. You can play games with the DeX 12 and Virtual Reality Enhanced too. However, this gaming computer rather gives you its best performance at 1000 ADIP. For the games like Cyberpunk 2077, Assassin's Creed, Valhalla, Watch Dogs Legion, it gives up to 50 FPS. Whereas, for Total War, Three Kingdoms, Rise of the Tomb Raider, Just Cause 4, and Players Unknown's Battlegrounds are having more than 80 FPS. The design of the iBuypower 1000 EV2 is something in between the fancy-looking, colorful PC to less shocking and decency. It does have all that RGB lighting and the see-through glass panel, yet it is still maintaining its mark of gravity towards integrity. The front of the desktop consists of an RGB strip, and the ceiling is also putting a tinted spotlight on the components within the tower. Despite all its good looks, it lacks liquid cooling features, and the case is little cramped unfavorable to upgrades. Thus, the cooling efficacy fully depends on the fans. Number 8 position is held by iBuypower Element Mr. 9320 Desktop. If your pocket does not allow you to go any farther than $1,000, then there is no better option than iBuypower Element Mr. 9320. In this model, you are again getting the 10th generation Intel Core Iceman 10700F 8-core processor with a boost frequency of up to 4.8 GHz. Though it has a GTX 1660 Ti video card in the case to offer, which has 6GB GDDR6 VRAM with 1500 MHz base clock and 1770 MHz boost clock. Further, it has 16GB RAM, 240GB SSD, and 1TB HDD massive storage. With a great value and enough power, Mr. 9320 is a great gaming PC you can have. It is capable of pouncing on more than mainstream gaming and gets you more frame rates than what we use to expect from a GTX video card today. This model is giving more or less similar gaming performance to the iBuypower 1000 EV2. Although it lacks real-time ray tracing but is very much capable of giving the best VR gaming performance even with the popular VR headsets too. GTX 1660 Ti is mainly a 1000 ADIP gaming video card, sufficient enough to get the main juices for you. For the Cyberpunk 2077, Metro Exodus, and Watch Dogs Legions, you can have up to 50 FPS. Whereas you are going to have more than 60 FPS on Death Stranding, The Division 2, Just Cause 4, and Hitman 2. Unlike the iBuypower 1000 EV2 we have reviewed earlier, Mr. 9320 is getting all the crazy looks in interior as well as exterior you might be missing in the previous model. The case is in standard size with all the components wisely placed, and giving up enough space to radiate heat and let the upgrading easily done. The front and the side panels are glass tempered with glass finish with a glossy texture. There are three RGB ring lights fans at the front, and one at the ceiling to spotlight the interior. Overall, it's a powerful and strongly built with alluring design. Next, at number 9, we have iBuypower Pro Revolt 2 9330. In a small form factor, iBuypower Pro is having an incredibly powerful configuration to offer. It has 10th generation Intel Core IFF 10600K 6-core processor with 16-thread, 4.10 GHz base frequency, and 4.8 GHz boost frequency. It has a GTX 1660 Super video card with 6GB GDDR6 video memory, 1530 MHz base clock, and 1785 MHz boost clock. It has 8GB RAM, 240GB SSD, and 1TB HDD storage, and an LAN-ready SSD swapping. Revolt 2 is a great gaming desktop with nicely picked configuration that is affordable under $1,000 within this specific budget. Intel IFF is nearly giving the same boost clock as Intel Iceman, and the GTX 1660 Super is close to GTX 1660 Ti. As a result, both the cards are equally good for gaming at 1000 ADIP and can handle AAA game titles with sufficient frame rates. It is giving 48 FPS on Cyberpunk 2077, 47 FPS on Control, 60 FPS to 70 FPS on Borderlands 3, Gear Tactics, Final Fantasy Roman 15, and Division 2. Whereas more than 70 FPS on Shadow of the Tomb Raider, Just Cause 4, Hitman 2, and Players Unknown Battlegrounds. This is the most intriguing part of this specific gaming machine. It is a compact PC for gaming with a highly attractive and innovative design. If you are the one who needs something unusual on the table and have tried a mini PC, cube-shaped desktops, and triangle computers, then this one is going to be your next pick for sure. Revolt 2 has nailed the aestheticism and groundbreaking design in order to double the thrill and excitement of gaming. Looking at its overall build, there's a central lid on top to expose the working GPU fan, and the front is having an SSD swapping lid. It supports 120mm liquid cooling if you are missing this feature in previous models. There are 16 million colors from RGB lighting coming from the innards. Besides, if you aim to upgrade this PC, then it may be difficult since the compact design does not allow much to get in that easily, though the open of the chassis is toolless. Finally, the number 10 position is dominated by Rog Strix GA15DH Gaming PC, another great configuration pack for combating competitive gaming. This is Rog Strix GA15DH Gaming PC with Ryzen 5 3600X, the third generation 6-core processor with 12 threads, 3.8 GHz base clock, and 4.4 GHz boost clock. This pre-built gaming PC owns a GTX 1660 Super 6GB GDDR6 video card with up to 1785 MHz boost frequency. Further, it has 8GB RAM, 256GB SSD, and 1TB HDD. Gaming is a graphic-centric task, and with GTX 1660 Super, you can have nice and smooth 1080p gaming without tweaking much for the settings to get enough frame rates. As described earlier, GTX 1660 Super can handle AA games at 1080p, but the higher you set the resolution than this, the lower you get the frame rates. Asus ROG Strix GA15DH has its own symbolic design. This model is not coming in a standard size of chassis, but a little bulging design you can expect. Not a glossy one, but a matte black touch. That's why this unit is a bit heavy too. Keeping in mind, manufacturer has eased the maneuvering of the desktop by giving a handle on top of it. There's a power button on the front beside an RGB LED strip slash, and a venting grill too. Then there is a side hood as well to place your headset on it. The case is adorned with Asus Aura Sync RGB lighting, which syncs with your overall setup if they are from Asus. A side glass tempered panel showcasing the internal components. However, there's no liquid cooling, but the process of heat dissipation is purely dependable on the fans of the CPU and GPU alone. That's all for today. We upload product review videos every single day, so don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon for the upcoming video notification.